Welcome to Friends School Lisburn.
Welcome to St. Dominic's Grammar School for Girls.
I want us to think back to when we first met until now. What have we done?
Working with another school was really interesting because we got to realise how the prejudices against Protestants weren't really what they seemed like, and we learned that we have more of a shared history than what we realised.
It also showed us that even if they're from if they have different beliefs and they're in a different school, we're still studying the same things.
I thought it would be a bit awkward and we wouldn't really talk to each other, but we've made really good friends and we've even went to train with a couple of them.
And you learned a lot about, the history aspect was good, but you learned a lot about each other, and it nearly felt that even at the end of the residential they were, your friends as well. You could just sit and talk to them as much as your own.
This isn't an exercise in politeness, okay? I don't want you to be rude, God help us, but I don't mind you engaging this.
We have a very vibrant history department, very high uptake, and the girls absolutely love the subject. But one of the things I had in mind to improve an already good product was to look at history in a shared way. And I ended up going to Facing History in Ourselves conference, where I met Iris Bradfield, and we germinated an idea between us that we'd look at 1916 and look at it as a tale of two stories, looking at the Somme and the Easter Rising.
And what memories, I just said, Corrymeela, the blue eye, brown eyes, the experiment thing, and the wee film, and the fire alarm going off.
That was the best part of the project was was the residential at Corrymeela. Maybe at the start when we met it was a bit, tight, you didn't want to really talk to anybody else, but near that night when we did the ghost walk and all, it was really enjoyable and just a really all-around great experience.
We learned about the shared history and it's Protestants and Catholics and they work together.
My favourite part was probably when we did all the questions at Corrymeela, when you put up the propaganda on the sheet and we had to describe how it was useful and how it persuaded people to join the army for the Catholics and the Protestants.
At the Somme, we made memorials and we done them in mixed groups and we done it with clay, but we had to present them at the end.
We learnt a lot from the Somme Heritage Centre. We learnt the conditions in the trenches and how hard it was for all the soldiers. We learnt about all the memorials and how they were built and what they mean.
This is called A Man in a Boat. It's a memorial remembering all the people who didn't come home or were never found.
I thought the best part of the project was when we went to Dublin, the Corrymeela Jail and Island Bridge, because I'm most interested in the part about the rebels and the Easter Rising.
So we got a chance to go around the jail and look at all where the rebels were staying and all, and we got a chance to see where some of the rebels were killed.
Green is kind of nationalist, orange is unionist, and white is peace.
We also went to the Garden of Remembrance, where we learned about the poppy and the symbols and what they meant. We went there because to remember the people in Ireland who died in the First World War.
Some young people have developed specific friendships out of it and meaningful friendships that will last. Other people have put question marks in their own mind about how they relate to people. And that's maybe one of the most profound aspects of change, that when you place that question mark within yourself, that makes it uncomfortable for you to just slip back into easy assumptions.
Many things surprised me in this aspect of history, when the UVF fought against the British for home rule, or that Catholics fought in the war for the British.
I found out whenever the Easter Rising was happening in Dublin, the people of Dublin didn't want it to happen in the first place, and then whenever they were executed, it was just one of the factors that changed the opinions of the people in Ireland.
What surprised me most really was how well some of us have got to know each other and how close we've all became, and coming from two different sides of Northern Ireland and very different opinions, it's been good to get to know new people and despite the opinions and differences.
When I see the rewards through the children and how they're connecting together and how they're making the connections with history as well, and this year the uptake for GCSE history in itself and their preparedness from the exam they did recently, I must say personally I'm getting a lot out of it. All the hard work we're putting in is definitely worthwhile.
I entered into the project, I think, because even if these kids haven't lived through the Troubles, which obviously they haven't, they are, you know, post-Troubles children, the divisions are so vast and so deep, and in ways that aren't always obvious, that it's worth doing it for that reason alone. And if we don't do it, we're abrogating our responsibility to that generation.
And as they went into battle,
I definitely recommend the project to other schools and people, because it's been really fun getting to know other people, learn history while you're with your friends, and just getting out to the trips and staying like in Corrymeela and things. It's been really fun.
It just shows two different sides of story and shows how they're actually connected, even though you wouldn't think they're connected.
You get a chance to learn about how the history was shared, and like maybe you were a wee bit biased when you first went to like learn about the project and took part in it, but it was good in the end because you have more of like different views.
I think it's important that we learn about our own history so we can learn from it, from what happened, like the Troubles and stuff, so they don't happen again.
I do believe that other schools should do a project like this, because we bond with others and you can make new friends, and even if people are strangers, you get to know them as friends and then you can speak out to them better.
Yeah, I definitely think that schools should do a project like this, because people have like strong prejudices based on other people, and like this project really opened like my eyes to see how the prejudices were all wrong.
I would recommend the project because it's something that we've never done before, especially going with other schools and learning about things you hadn't done before in the same. You may have thought something different and learned about it, changed your opinion on it.
For me as a teacher, it just drove home the point that I knew when I was younger, and I think I'd forgotten, that if we're not about changing our society, we're not about anything at all.